The Coalition's future will be decided in the next few hours, with Barnaby Joyce facing a fresh challenge as Peter Dutton inherits the Liberal leadership. Live now to Fiona Whelan. Fee, a busy day in Canberra.
Ali, Coalition MPs are arriving at Parliament House this morning ready to pick their new leaders. Now, one thing is looking certain, and that is Peter Dutton will be the opposition leader. Scott Morrison will officially step down as the Liberal leader today, and the former Defence Minister is expected to be elected for the role unopposed. However, when it comes to the Nationals leadership, it appears things will be less predictable. So Barnaby Joyce is facing a challenge from his deputy leader, David Littleproud. Victorian MP Darren Chester has also confirmed that he'll throw his hat into the ring. This morning, we asked Mr. Joyce how he's feeling about his chances.
I believe that people in the room will make up their mind. Happy to stand by my record and let people make their choice.
So who do you think would be your best replacement if you come to that?
I don't know, Jesus, Muhammad, I don't know.
And today, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese is working on his cabinet. His full ministry will be sworn in on Wednesday. So many familiar faces in Canberra this week, but certainly some new titles to get used to.
Jesus or Muhammad. He's colourful. Thanks, V.
Oh. Welcome back to the show. Well, the honeymoon is almost over. Labor now facing the challenge of delivering... It's a good song, isn't it? $45 billion of election promises without stoking inflation and forcing interest rates even higher. For more, we're joined by Liberal MP Stuart Robert and 2GB's Chris Smith. Morning, guys. Nice morning. To see you this morning. Stuart, morning. First up, someone to need needed to reel in the spending, right? It's what you guys should have done before the election.
Well, we did. There was $103 billion worth of saving measures or budget adjustments that came through. Over 70% of that was saved for budget reduction. Unfortunately, the incoming government has done the exact opposite. $7.8 billion more in cash expenditure and over $40 billion hidden off the profit and loss, off balance sheet. Standard of Poor's now, the credit agency, saying this could affect our AAA rating, and Labor's only been in office for a week.
I'll come back to that in a second. But who's going to be your leader and deputy?
Well, I guess two guarantees. One, Peter Dutton will be leader, and the next one, Susan Lee. Both will be sworn in, if you like, by the party room, uncontested.
You happy about that? You don't seem over the moon.
Oh, absolutely happy with that. Carl, not as happy as I'll be when you smash Hamish Blake, but super happy about what we're going to do today in the party room and super happy about the leadership team we're bringing in.
I'm not sure that's going to happen. But anyway, I'm glad you're super happy. What about the Nationals? David Littleproud, will he knock over Barnaby?
We'll wait and see what the Nationals do. Carl, they had a great campaign, held all their seats to their credit. David Littleproud, a great colleague of mine, of course, from Queensland. So I wish them both well as they go head-to-head.
You obviously think it's going to be David Littleproud, though?
I think it'll be close.
OK, that's a yes this morning, Smithy. It's as close as we get.
I have a feeling that there may be a change for three reasons. A change of look for the Coalition. He has been associated, Barnaby, with three of the previous Liberal Prime Ministers. Mm. I think maybe there's a feeling within the party for a change for that purpose. And bear in mind, of the 12 of 16 seats that they hold, the Nats, they had a swing against them in those 12 of 16
seats. They did pretty well, though. Barnaby did pretty
well.
They
retained all their seats. He didn't make too many wrong errors. But one thing he said a week ago, which was maybe the party room needs to negotiate and think again about the climate policy. That scared a few who in the party think we need to embrace it a little bit more.
My worry is with Labor, well, it doesn't really need to look after the bush. And unfortunately, there are a lot of programs that were going to be built in the bush, a lot of big infrastructure projects that now don't need to be built. That's my biggest worry.
Well, that's true. And there wasn't much said by Labor about the bush. Mm. Very little throughout that campaign. And they don't have that experience. That's not in their DNA, and it's certainly not in their current numbers, those that are holding seats.
And an effective National Party will do that, right?
Yeah.
And it does need to lift its game, doesn't it? David? Stuart?
David Littleproud. Who's David, Carl?
I was saying David Littleproud. It's Monday morning.
The Nats have held all their seats. They represent the rural constituency exceptionally well. Labor hasn't got a clue. Goodness, their rural spokesman, their agricultural minister, will probably be a MP from Tasmania who holds an urban seat. Only the National Party is capable of really representing rural Australian, Carl. We all know that. And they'll contest and they'll fight that and they'll represent that very hard for the next 3 years.
It is going to be much harder to deliver all those promises, and they're going to find that in government, right? And they're going to have to do something about the budget.
The budget. Well, in some ways, you said the honeymoon is almost over. I have a feeling this warning from Standard & Poor's about losing our AAA credit rating is a realisation, reality is biting, that the honeymoon is really over, because he is now in the A-League, Anthony Albanese. He has to work out, well, hang on, those $45 billion promises I gave during the election, maybe they're all on hold, because we haven't lost a AAA credit rating, I don't think, since 1986.
Stuart, you've got, if you look in the papers today, another 6 years in opposition to look forward to.
They said the same thing about Kevin the Messiah Rudd, except after 2 years and 4 or 5 months, all that went splendidly well for them. So we'll leave the papers and the commentary aside. We'll hold this government to account, starting, as Chris said, with the AAA credit rating. Only 9 countries in the world have got it, and it's taken Anthony Albanese less than a week for one of the credit agencies to put them on notice that their off-balance sheet spending is a real threat.
Talking of great country, Australia, infrastructure, when I grew up in Cairns, this was one of the major things you would drive past every morning on the way to school at St. Augustine's, the Captain Cook statue. We didn't really, after a while, you don't really even give it a second look after a couple of years of going to school, past it every day. Well, it's been taken down as a symbol of colonialism, that outstretched hand, apparently a Nazi salute all the way along. It's making way for a hospital, I think. What do you think, Smithy?
This stinks. I hate it. You can't change your history. The good part of history, the bad part of history, you can't change it and think we're going to fix problems in society. I hate this. What are we going to do now? The James Cook Highway, the James Cook Road goes, James Cook University, we've got to rename that as well.
Yeah.
The bloke in his time was one of the great navigators, one of the great, in Spartan times, I might add, great navigators in his time. We can't use the expectations and the morals of today to judge those in history.
Well said. Also, Stuart, Possum Magic, the Very Hungry Caterpillar, Harry McClary, Wombat Stew, we're going on a bear hunt, and Where the Wild Things Are, they've been labelled too old and not culturally diverse enough.
They are outstanding books. Harry McClary from Donaldson's Dairy, are you kidding me? We should just leave these things alone. Some of this postmodern wokeism is simply getting out of control, be it books, be it Enid Blyton, be it statues. Can we just embrace our history? Can we criticise if it needs to be criticised? Can we enjoy it and love it all at the same time?
I'll tell you what I was enjoying and loving this yesterday at the airport. Take a close-up look at this, folks. Rocking the biker jacket. I mean, look at him go, Stuart.
It's a new season, Carl. It's a new season. Wait and see what I wear when you take out Hamish Black. It's going to be huge.
You've changed the curtains.
It's a Springsteen look. It's almost Springsteen.
Yeah, it's very good, very good. Good on you, Smithy.
Good on you, thank you, Carl.
And thank you, too, to David there in Canberra, a.k.a. Stuart.